Okay. So thanks for coming. Today I'm going to talk about recent work on contextual bandits. These are actually two pieces of joint work with two groups of people. So they are Alec Agnew, Shigar Agnew, Nikhil Gavanon, Daniel Xu, Sanyan Kale, John Lamper, and Rob Shapiro, across four organizations. So let me start with the application, why contextual bandit is a useful thing to think about. In my talk, please feel free to stop me for questions at any time. So nowadays, for big companies like Microsoft, Google, and Yahoo, usually the company has multiple products that interact with users. Microsoft, for example, has a search engine, has the Office operating system and mobile platforms, etc. All these things users engage in interaction with the product. Right? So it's not a one-off situation where Microsoft sends something to the user and they stop. That's not the case. There's a loop between the user and the company in terms of in the interaction of this form. So in particular, when the user visits a Microsoft store or a web page owned by Microsoft, the company sees this contextual information, like whether the user is a male or female, the income, or the query is submitted to the search engine, etc., or time of the day, etc. And then, depending on what the product is, Microsoft can take one of a few actions to serve the user. For example, it can show an ad, or return a search result page. Or in a cell phone, it could be a Cortana system that tries to schedule a meeting on a calendar. So this is the action that is taken to the user. And in return, we observe whether the user is happy or not. So that's the reward, the view value that we try to maximize. Rewards are usually in terms of clicks or adoptions and recommendation problems or purchases in advertising, things like that. And then there's a loop between the two parties. And as time goes on. And in this loop, we want to maximize total reward that we can extract from users. For this kind of interaction problems, you can see that the structure is quite different from the majority in machine learning, where the focus is mostly on pre-prediction, such as decision trees or SVMs, where you're given a set of ID data and you try to obtain good generalization error, generalization of future data. Here you have a loop, and in the loop, the action you choose determines what data you have, and that data will determine whether you can build a good policy based on this data, and whether the policy will be good enough to serve your future users. The two kinds of interaction problems, roughly speaking, one is called reinforcement learning, where the agent is engaged in the multi-state decision making with the notion of state, such as a robot. Here, in this talk, I'm going to focus on a somewhat simpler problem, but which is still interesting and very useful. It's called contextual bandits. So for the rest of this talk, I will first explain what contextual bandit is, and I will show you some concrete applications of it. And then in the second part, I talk about Minimonster, which is a recent algorithm that achieves a very non-trivial theoretical guarantees. And then I'll briefly go over the third part of Minimonster with constraints that tackles contextual bandits with global objective constraints. So let's start with contextual bandit. So here's one slide that explains what contextual bandit is. One good example of application is news recommendation. When you go to a web page, the website is going to recommend one or few articles to the user, so that in the hope that these articles will be interesting to the user. So in the language of contextual bandit, we're given a set of X, which is a set of users. Set of A is the set of actions, is the set of articles that you can show to the user, recommend to the user. And then you have a pi, which is a set of mapping called policies that tells you for this user which article I'm going to recommend. So it's just a function from X to A. And then the interaction in multi-band, the contextual band is as follows. For T from 1 to infinity or to some number, Then you observe for each step, you're serving one user, one particular user. You observe the user information, where the user could come from RID from some distribution. And then you can recommend one of the articles to the user based on the information you have. And then we obtain a reward from the user. Usually in this kind of problem, we are interested in maximizing the total number of clicks. So you can define reward as one when user clicks on the article, or the reward zero if the user doesn't click. So the average reward will be the click-through rate, which is a very important quantity in industry applications. And based on this the information X, A, and R, now you can update the policy to the next one, the party plus one. And this repeats. Informally, in this process, the algorithm tries to approach the optimum policy that maximizes the sum of rewards. Okay. This is the informal goal. Formally, people are more comfortable working with something called regret. It's actually almost the same as the sum of reward, except it's reversed. So what is regret? Is the difference, expectation of difference between two things. R sub t star is the optimal policy's reward. Right? If you knew the optimal policy in this policy space, uppercase pi, then you could have used that policy to serve users. And that's the rewards you get from the t user. And you compute the difference from the optimal reward and the reward you get in this process. And this, by definition, this is always non-negative. You take an expectation, and then, the expectation is non-negative, and then you normalize it by 1 over t. So when you say an algorithm learns in the contextual bandit setting, it means that when t goes to infinity, this average step, average regret decays to zero fast, a sublinear t. That means that in the limit, the algorithm is approaching the behavior of the optimal policy, so it learns. And of course, you want an algorithm that has low regret, as slow as possible. That means it learns faster. So this is contextual bandit. And this is the one application that we worked on at Yahoo before. There are more applications here. For example, in advertising, when you submit a query, the website may decide which ads to show in the hope of maximizing revenue or CPM, depending on what you care about. So in this case, the context could be a query and maybe user information, and the actions are the ads you show, and the reward will be click or not, or no click or revenue. And then in web search, you could be using multiple places. For example, the highlighted part will be is something we call snippet. You could use this is a you can formulate it as a contextual bandit problem where the condition on the query and the user, the system decides what snippet to show on the page in the hope to maximize or optimize user experience. And also how to decide how many sublinks to show, the vertical search, which vertical search to results to display, things like that. Local search, query suggestion for local search, and search ads, etc. So there, and in fact, this is just a subset of problems. For example, some people also use ideas in bandits to optimize hyperparameters in complicated learning systems. So that you don't have to two parameters manually, but instead use ideas from bandits to find the optimal hyperparameters.